Larry Ridley, and this is 17 on EA Sports. Anticipation is bouncing for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's the Patriots going up against the Dolphins. With that, let's head on down to Miami, where we'll hand it over to the two men calling our game. That's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, we've got an AFC East matchup between the New England Patriots and the Miami Dolphins. Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27.
And LeGarrette Blount just does not go down easy. You know, from my experience as a defensive back, this was a difficult guy to try and tackle because of the force that he runs with, and he's not going to be daunted no matter if it's the first quarter or the fourth quarter, Brandon.
Well, what shocks me about last year, 18 touchdowns. I mean, the yards were pretty good, 1161. But when I think of New England, I don't think of a running back getting 18 touchdowns.
You know, that to me is the combo that made the 2016 season for him. Most yards in his career, most touchdowns in his career by far. And he's the type of guy that, hey, you want to give it to me inside the five? He doesn't believe anyone's going to stop him.
Brady gives now to Blount, and he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And a look at the starters for the Miami defense.
The competition to go to the Pro Bowl at safety is fierce in the NFL, but Rashad Jones makes his case year in and year out as one who should go.
His throw incomplete. Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. Third down here.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
So third and five, defensively expecting pass. They've got six DBs out there. He'll get it outside to Gronkowski. Gronkowski may have had to miss a Super Bowl with the injury, but he was active in that parade, and now he's back on the field. And I'll tell you what, something you mentioned to me is that he was a big cheerleader for his teammates, never hung his head through the injury, celebrated with him all the way through the title.
We've seen superstars in the past, when their team does well without them, they're happy, but they recede into the background, right? They get out of the way because it does hurt them a little bit. They do have pride. They want to feel like, hey, without me, they may take a little bit of a step back. But with Gronk, you never saw that. You saw him with him every step of the way, cheering his team on, happy for their success. They went 11-0 without him in 2016, but I know this, they don't want to try it again.
No,
they want the big fella back.
Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. And he'll bring this one inside the 35.
For someone who piled up the yardage that Jay Ajayi did in 2016, I think it was a strange type of a year. How many runners do you know that will end a season with more 200-yard games on the ground than 100-yard games and end up over 1,000?
Very, very strange. Three 200-yard games, just one 100-yard game. All in all, though, how do you see a season? A rough start, but looked pretty good in the end.
Rough start, but a really good offensive line that continues to grow. I think the future's really bright for Jay Ajayi and the Dolphins next season.
Now it's Ajayi, and he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
There are so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day, get the blocker away, and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
Here's New England defensively. Last year, the number one overall defense as far as points given up goes. And they've got a lot coming back in 2017.
Now, they certainly do. And let's go back to the Super Bowl. Trey Flowers, who was their leading sack guy in 2016, he had 7 in the regular season. He was a monster in the Super Bowl against Atlanta. He's back there for them. How about Dante Hightower, linebacker? His first Pro Bowl in 2016. And then, just moving on back to the secondary, Devin McCourty, the guy who quarterbacks him back as safety. He's been to the Pro Bowl as a corner and as a free safety.
Kenny Stills, the intended receiver, and it brings up fourth down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Okay, partners, New England comes out here to take the field on offense. Yeah, this is such an interesting story, how they've been able to do it year after year after year. Guys talk about parity in the NFL. Well, New England has kind of transcended that parity, and they've done it with guys that you don't normally think of as household names.
The parts keep changing for New England. That's the amazing part on offense, all right? Offensive linemen change, receivers change, running backs change. We know the one constant is Tom Brady, and that's a huge deal for them. But to be able to do it in what you call the parity times, and you're exactly right, everyone's supposed to be pretty equal. New England still a top 10 offense year in and year out. In 2016, they were number four, and that helped them with a number one ranked defense as well.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Here's Brady to throw, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Brady now to throw. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and the Dolphins get the football in great field position, and they'll start this drive with very good field position. First and 10, Tannehill. And his throw's going to be incomplete. His tight end, Jordan Cameron, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on first down.
Got to give them a little extra confidence there, starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down.
Devontae Parker, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Incomplete pass on second down. And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Ten yards to go on third. So the D-line's going to spread out. So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Now Williams. Doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one.
Now, that was a big run. It takes him all the way down to the one-yard line, and that'll shake the confidence of any defense. So when they're looking for a little bit of support now, looking at the...
And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Damian Williams punching it in from a yard away, and the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with the battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Now Deion Lewis to return, and he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Here come the Patriots again on offense, the Super Bowl champions, and boy, they have been able to do it a lot of times, Charles, with unsung heroes, haven't they? Look at the names that led them through the playoffs. Hogan, White, Lewis, guys you just wouldn't think of.
Yeah, Deion Lewis, a fifth-round pick, three touchdowns against Houston in the divisional round. Chris Hogan, undrafted. He ends up having 180 yards in receptions, including five plays of 20 yards or more against the Pittsburgh Steelers. And how about James White, a fourth-round pick out of Wisconsin? Think about who he played behind while he was at Wisconsin, and he turns out to be the unsung hero of the Super Bowl. Would have been the MVP if it wasn't for Tom Brady.
And you mentioned James White at Wisconsin. He was behind who? Melvin Gordon and Monte Ball, right?
That's correct. And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense is able to run successfully.
Now Brady. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Koumissi from that outside linebacker spot. He's able to get in there for a loss of nine. On third and long, it's Brady. And this one complete to Martellus Bennett. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down. Brady not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it here on fourth.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kiko Alonso. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
Ajayi hit. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And trailing on the scoreboard last time, able to force the fumble, I'm sure they'd like to do that again.
That's exactly right, because what they did last time has helped them stay in this game. Being opportunistic, taking the ball away, that can help keep a game tight.
Yeah, we'll see if they can be opportunistic here. They'll be looking to force another turnover. Shift together here from the D-line. Now a toss play. It's Ajayi. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time, but you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt. All right, let's go ahead and try and get into the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys, because the offensive guys are always taught, find the first down sticks and make the play. On defense, what do you want to do? Guard the first down line. Make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They were able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
Flushed out right. And he finds Stills complete. And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line.
I think they might have surprised him there, partner, because you try and guard the first down line first and foremost to stop them there. And they just went ahead and bypassed that in a big way and took a big shot downfield.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Tough day. tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They run with Ajayi. That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves him with third down and just a yard to go. So with that, we come upon the 2-minute warning here on the NFL on EA Sports. Tannehill going to throw on third and one. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Jordan.